Field of Rural Life magazine. We're here up in Scotland. It's AgriScot. And it's great meeting up with Polaris. Now, Lee, this morning we've been having a little bit of a chat. Now, this is a fantastic vehicle. Now, just explain a little bit about Polaris and what we have here.
Well, Polaris are a North American company.
Yeah.
And in the winter time there, as you can imagine, they get a lot of snow.
A lot of white stuff.
Yeah. So, and last year we had the same, didn't we?
We all got too badly.
We all got cut out. So, this year, last year we were inundated with telephone calls asking, do we have ploughs in stock?
Yeah.
And frankly, we just didn't have enough to cope with the demand.
Right.
And the weather is what drove that.
Yeah.
This year, the dealers have been a little bit more proactive.
Yeah, sure.
And they're fitting this accessory to the front of the Polaris machine in preparation for what is going to be a bad winter again.
So, fantastic piece of equipment. Fits most of the vehicles?
Yeah, really, you're best to have four-wheel drive.
Yeah.
Some of the machines on the stand here are two-wheel drive, and with a plough on, you might
struggle
a little bit. But
yeah,
a four-wheel drive machine, whether it be an ATV or a utility truck, with a plough in the front, is going to cope, yeah.
Think Polaris, correct me if I'm wrong, back in the 50s?
They're more than 50 years old now. 2004 was their 50th anniversary.
Right, okay.
So 1954 was when they were founded. They kind of invented the snowmobile, or they did invent the snowmobile.
Yes.
They've gone on from there to produce all sorts of different machines. Got involved in the world of all-terrain vehicles, early 80s, 1983 from memory.
Yeah.
And they've kind of just evolved from there.
So we've got everything from the Charles right up through to your...
Yeah.
I see over there on the other side we have a six-wheel drive?
That's correct. I mean, that's the thing that's quite interesting about the company. I mean, the annual turnover of the company, 75% of that is down to the fact we make off-road vehicles.
Really?
And we do anything from a little 50cc in pink for a girl, right the way through to a six-wheel drive machine that we've recently secured an order for 15 units to hazardous area response teams across the UK.
Okay.
So we kind of do everything. So everything from kids right the way through to the extreme off-roaders.
Okay, now how about new technologies?
New technology, well, the two big stories for us this year is that we launched a mid-size chassis.
Yeah.
So basically, instead of a three-seater full-size Ranger, we now have a two-seater.
Right.
We have a 400cc petrol engine.
Yeah.
We have an electric version of that machine as well.
Interesting,
which is obviously quite exciting.
Yes.
And just in the last 3 or 4 months, we've launched a full-size chassis, like you see here, but with a diesel engine option.
Interesting.
Which is a first for us.
Okay, lead us on now to the electric version.
Yeah, this is really does what it says on the tin, really. It's a proper all-terrain vehicle. Now, there are other electric trucks on the market which tend to derive from golf cars. Nothing wrong with these. They've got a place and they do a job in those environments. But with this particular machine, it is an off-road vehicle.
Yeah, sure.
So what it comes with, all the bells and whistles that you'd expect from the other trucks.
Yes.
But instead of an electric, a petrol or a diesel engine, you've got electric.
Fantastic.
What
are we looking like?
Well, it's very simple. Everything's inbuilt.
Yeah.
Your charger is inbuilt into the machine, so you don't have a separate charger system.
Okay.
You open up the glove box.
Yeah.
In there is a lead with a 13-amp socket on the end.
Straight into the wall.
Simple. Charge it up overnight, and then you've got up to 50 miles driving in any one day. You've got three options. You've got the high ratio, which will give you about 25, 26 miles per hour.
All right.
You've got a low option, which you would use with a four-wheel drive system engaged when you're doing
tricky
off-road conditions.
Yes.
And in the middle, you've got max range.
Oh, right.
That just cuts the power back on the machine a little bit.
Yeah.
And in a facility such as this, where the ground's pretty flat and easy going, you should get up to 50 miles in max range.
Fantastic.
Right, so Lee, to get us started, what's the procedures?
Well, it's really quite straightforward now. We're fairly flat here, we're on the tarmac, so we'll have her in two-wheel drive and with the back differential unlocked. Turn the key, tells us we've got the park in the neutral, foot on the brake, into forward.
Off with the handbrake.
Release the handbrake. And there we go.
Fantastic.
So we're going to decide what we're going to use. You've got forward, neutral or reverse.
Okay.
You've got three drive options.
Right.
The first one
gives
you two-wheel drive.
Yes.
And unlocks the rear differential.
Oh, right.
So
yeah,
if you're on turf or on tarmac and you wanted to turn nice and tight without scrubbing the tyres or lifting the dirt, you would have it in this option.
Right.
Yep.
Yes.
The next click of the switch locks the rear axle so that the two wheels are going to turn at the same.
Right.
Yep.
Okay.
And then the last option is all-wheel drive.
Oh, interesting.
And
okay.
I say all-wheel drive because unlike a lot of our competitors who have a four-wheel drive system, our all-wheel drive system works just ever so slightly different. When the back wheels detect wheel spin, the front wheels come into play.
Oh, right.
Yeah, giving you proper all-wheel drive.
I'm with you. Yes.
If you're climbing a hill and it's muddy,
yes,
you want the four wheels working for you.
Yes.
Not three and a half wheels working
yes,
for you.
Yes.
And the Polaris system, all-wheel drive is what we have in all our four-wheel drive machines.
Interesting.
Okay.
Wonderful.
So here we are. It's all fairly flat. We're on the tarmac, so we'll select it here so we have the two-wheel drive with the back differential unlocked. If you want 50 miles out of this machine, you select max, which is right in the middle here.
Right, okay.
Click it forward to high, and that will give you top speed.
Yes.